MedCram.com.
Well, welcome to another MedCram lecture at MedCram.com. We're going to talk about lung cancer staging. So once you've made a diagnosis of lung cancer, there's two major types of lung cancer. The first one that you should know is something called non-small cell lung cancer. And what are the types of non-small cell lung cancer? You've got squamous, you've got adenocarcinoma, and you've got large cell. Now, another type of adenocarcinoma is known as bronchioalveolar carcinoma, which name has recently changed to adenocarcinoma in situ. Typically looks like ground glass opacification. Squamous cell carcinoma, it's your P63 positive, cytokeratin 5 and 6 positive, usually has hypercalcemia, typically at the later stages. If that's the case, it's going to be positive for the parathyroid hormone-related peptide, which is a paraneoplastic syndrome. For small cell, which is the second type, so not non-small cell, but small cell lung carcinoma, this is the small blue cell, or oat cell as it used to be called, and it can have a paraneoplastic syndrome of, well, various different things. It could be Eaton-Lambert syndrome, you could have a SIADH, or even a Cushing syndrome type. And so these two are very different. The small cell lung carcinoma typically is more aggressive. The non-small cell lung carcinoma is not as aggressive. In some cases, you could even cure these if they're found early enough. So the way that we're going to talk about this is using something called the T, or the tumor, the N, or the node, and the M stage. Now, these combine to give you your overall stage, which will determine the treatment for lung cancer. So the T stands for tumor, or tumor size. The N is how many nodes are positive, and the M is if there are metastases and where the metastases are. You can use the T and M for small cell lung carcinoma, but it's actually not as useful. Typically, we use something called limited or extensive staging. We can talk about that in another lecture. Where the TN and M staging is used almost exclusively is in the non-small cell lung carcinoma. So that's what we're going to talk about, is the staging for non-small cell lung carcinoma. And the reason why this is important is because there are different treatments for each of the overall stages. So I don't want you to get confused. There is a T stage, there is an N stage, and there is an M stage. And then we put those all together and we come up with a total stage. And so the question is, how does that happen? Well, I want to explain that to you because it is a somewhat complex way of doing it. And you always wonder, well, how do they come up with the overall stage from a T, N, and M staging? So let's get into that. What we have here is the T stages. So there's a T1A, a T1B, a T2A, a T2B, and a T3, and finally a T4. That is combined with N0 through N3 stages. Has to do with the lymph nodes. And then finally, there is a M0, M1A, and an M1B. And those will give us our stages. So the first thing I want to do is I want to talk a little bit about the T stages. And now the T stages have to do with the actual tumor itself. So generally speaking, a T1A is any tumor that is less than 2 centimeters in size. A T1B is anything that is 2 to 3 centimeters inclusive. I put an underline there. A T2A would be anything from 3 to 5 centimeters. A T2B would be 5 to 7 centimeters. A T3 is 7+ centimeters. And by the way, these are inclusive here. And then finally, a T4 is anything that is large and involves the mediastinum. So if you have invasion of the mediastinum, structures of the mediastinum, for instance, the trachea or the esophagus. And sometimes there are multiple different things that are going to be included, and so you always pick the worst, okay? Now, there are other things that can give you a T2A or a T2B. For instance, if, and these are sort of combined here, so I'm going to erase this little dividing line, okay, because this would put it into a T2 stage. Anything that is greater than 2 centimeters from the carina. Remember what the carina is, it is where the trachea divides into the 2 main stem bronchi. So if there's a main stem bronchi tumor, if it is greater than 2 centimeters from the carina, it could fit into the T2 stage. Anything that causes a lobe to collapse, okay? As opposed to a whole lung to collapse. So anything that causes a lobe or anything that involves the visceral pleura. Now that's opposed to anything that is less than 2 centimeters from the carina, which would be a T3. Anything that causes a lung to collapse, or anything that involves the parietal pleura. Okay, visceral pleura, parietal pleura. Now there is one more thing that could give you a T3. And I'll put it up here in kind of pink so you can see it. But if you have 2 nodules in the same lobe, obviously in the same lung, what could give you a T4 is if you have 2 nodules in different lobes of the same lung. Okay, so for instance, if you had a nodule that you found, or a cancer that you found in the right upper lobe and in the right lower lobe, they would be 2 nodules that are different lobes but in the same lung. That would get you into a T4, regardless of how big they were. However, if you had 2 nodules that were in the right upper lobe, they would be in the same lobe, same lung. That would get you to a T3. Okay, so we're looking for the worst combination. If you had complete collapse of the right lung, that would get you a T3 because you have complete lung collapse. If you had something involving the chest wall, that is the parietal pleura, that would get you a T3. So the first thing you need to do whenever you see a tumor is figure out what T level it's going to be. Once you figure out what T level it is, then the next thing you need to do is you need to figure out what the N level is. So NO means that there are no nodes involved. So you can find that out early by looking at a CT scan to see if there are enlarged lymph nodes. You can somewhat confirm that by getting a PET scan to see if those nodes light up or not. But if it makes the difference between surgery or no surgery, you really want to confirm that with either a mediastinoscopy, which is more invasive, or which is less invasive would be EBUS. Okay? That's endoscopic bronchial ultrasound, where you actually go down there and take a sample with a needle. So if you have a tumor on the right side and you see no nodes, so no ipsilateral lymph nodes, mediastinal lymph nodes, subcarinal lymph nodes, then you would get an N0, which is very good. If you, however, you had Hilar lymphadenopathy, and these are gonna be double digit numbers. If they tell you it's lymph node number 12L, that means on the left side, it would be the 12th lymph node. Anything with double digits is gonna get you out into the hilum, which is pretty peripheral. And if that's involved, that would be an N1. If on the other hand, you are talking about mediastinal lymph nodes, so not hilar, but mediastinal, that would be an N2. Those are just typically single digit. And that would also include subcarinal, okay? Subcarinal lymph nodes. So mediastinal or subcarinal lymph nodes is going to be an N2, typically single digit lymph nodes. N3 would be back again to double digit, but it would be contralateral. So this is not good. This would be where you have a right-sided tumor, but a left-sided lymph node that is lighting up. That would be an N3. So that would be a Hilar lymph node on the other side. Could also be double digit. Okay, and then MO would be no metastasis anywhere else. Okay, so no mets. So the default would be 0. There's 2 situations that would get you an M1A. Number one, if you had a malignant pleural effusion. So if you did a thoracentesis and sent the cells off for cytology and they were positive, that would give you a malignant pleural effusion. You would be at a stage M1A. Another way is if you had 2 nodules in different lungs. So again, if you have two nodules in the same lobe, right upper lobe, that would be a T3. If you had two nodules in the same lung, but different lobes, that would be a T4. If you have two nodules in different lungs, so right upper lobe, left lower lobe, for instance, that would give you a M1A. An M1B would be anywhere outside of the chest. And I'll just say that if you meet the criteria, unfortunately, for M1A or an M1B, that's an automatic stage 4. We're going to write these stages in Roman numerals. So regardless of your N or T, if you meet any of these criteria, you're automatically a stage 4. So that's important, because if you've got a patient with a malignant pleural effusion, that automatically puts them at a stage M1A, which automatically gives them a stage 4. Okay, so let's go through these stages. So the first stage that you're going to have is overall stage 1A, and that's going to be here. 1A and 1A. This would be 1B. And that's where it would end. The next stage you would have is 2A and 2B. Down here you would have 2A, 2A, and 2A. This would be 2B. This would be 3A. This would be 3A, and this also would be 3A. All of these down here are 3As, except for one. This one here is 3B, and of course all of these along here are also 3B. Join us for the next video when I talk about how to remember this and the mnemonics and the treatments for all of these stages. Thanks for joining us, and join us at MedCram.com.